Shannon Blaise. Welcome to Booktopia.
Thank you very much. Good to be here.
We're here to talk about your new book, Design with Colour and Style.
Yep.
Your previous book was Design Your Home.
It was, so they're a little pigeon pair that work well together.
Now, I've got a quote here from Neil Whittaker. Shana is the original Duracell bunny.
Yeah.
Do you sleep? How do you fit all this into one little life?
Yeah, it's a bit like that. You just, I do sort of email my PA sometimes and go, what's my name today? I can't remember who I am. Look, it's full on. I love projects and lots of projects, and really that's what keeps me going. If I just had one or two things, I probably wouldn't achieve what I achieve now. And it goes back to that old saying, give something to a busy person to get it done. And
stress?
I don't really get stressed. My body does. My body goes a bit clunk maybe once a year and just says, I've had enough. I'm going, no, but there's more to do. I don't really take on a lot of stress. I don't sleep a lot. The mind is very active, and that's just sort of like working with that, because you do have to sleep. It is essential to make things happen. You know, I have a really small team. I've got a great PA. I've got a management team. I've got a couple of designers that do work for me, and you have to have good people with you. You can't do any of this if you haven't got a great team. And, you know, Selling Houses Australia, The Block, they're like big friendship families. That they are great people to work for. It's not a stressful situation in any of those moments. You know, it's lots of hard work, but it's great fun.
But being in front of the camera is not, like, it's not like normal life.
It's not normal. It's just, but I'm not normal.
Well, that's the answer.
I really do love what I do. And, you know, there is that also that old quote, you know, do what you love and you'll never work a day in your life. I reckon that's a lie. I work damn hard. I work really, really hard, and I love it.
Yeah. Well, this book is introducing colour into people's lives.
Yeah, and style.
And style. Both things can be intimidating. Colour can be really intimidating. People generally go into people's houses and go for the whites and the dull colours, and introducing colour in people's lives. How do you manage to do that to clients? I mean, sort of go, actually, I want to bring this into your life. I think this is the colour for you. Do you find resistance?
Oh, always resistance, because it comes down to people have this thought of everything should be neutral because it's going to date. I think that's the biggest thing. People have this massive fear that whatever they put in the home is going to date really quickly and devalue their home. But when you're doing your own colour scheme and your own style for your own interior, it shouldn't date because it's about you.
Yeah.
So what I do is find about them, what their history is, who they are, what they want the house to do for them, and then the colours come with that. And more often than not, I end up doing it quite a big strong colour in their house, and they thought, I would never go for this, but I absolutely love it. So it's tapping into the reasoning why you're scared of using colour, tapping in the reasoning of why you love colour, and trying to make them work together. And that's what I've done in the book.
So are you scanning somebody as they're talking to you, and you're sort of looking around their rooms and going, you're this particular colour? Or has it come out in what they tell you?
Definitely comes out in what they tell you.
So you can scan me and see my colours.
Well, not really, because I always wear black and white. Like, I just go for classic, but my big colour choices are turquoises and blues. But if I wear those colours often, it's very loud and it's very out there, and I've got a pretty loud personality, so I think people would just be putting shields up when I walk in the room. But I put the colour in my house to make me feel good, and that's my happy space, and that's what I want people to do. So just because you love a colour doesn't mean it has to go on the walls. Just because you love a colour, you don't have to wear it. It just means that it needs to be in your life, so the extension of you is in your home, and that's the most important thing.
When I'm walking down the street, sometimes I look at people and go, what do you, like, the match on a person in the
room.
And I think to myself that they're that loud out here.
Yeah.
I imagine what it's like in their home. Now, I'm thinking about you as a someone's friend, and you're coming over for dinner. Do people, I mean, I'd be frightened to reveal my rooms to you as a dinner guest.
Do you
go, look, I'm coming over, I'm not going to judge. I'm not going to make any judgments about your room.
I never do. Because the thing is, like, your hat judge is for a particular job, it's for a particular reason. And I think people's personal style in their own home, it's theirs. It's not there to be critiqued, and I don't think that's fair. It's only when they ask me the question. And I do get invited to a lot of dinners because they want me to help them. So it's almost like, now what do you think I should do here, and what should I do there? And I get lots of people asking for advice in a really good way. So that's good, but a lot of the time I turn around and say, this dinner's going to have to cost a lot more money if you want that advice.
It's like dentists and doctors get
exactly.
Say,
and
just check out my leg.
Yeah, exactly. It's very much like that. And look, it's fun. It just means that, you know, I am doing a good job and people do listen to my advice. So that's pretty cool.
So you're giving advice in your book. Now,
yeah.
Someone picks this book up. How should they use it? What are the things that in there that they can sort of take out?
This is a fun book. My first book, Design Your Home, is about the rules, the structure, and it came out of that question, where do I start?
Yeah.
So Design Your Home is about where do I start? This came out of the questions of like, what colour do I choose and what is my style? So it's answering those questions. So there's little formulas of colour that people don't really understand. And I've tried to put it in very simplistic ways of basic monochromatic, contrast colours and then base colours. And they're quite daunting, but I've tried to do it in a very simple way that people can work out a base structure of their colour scheme and then build in layers on top of that. I think one of the worst things you can do is try and get the book and think you can do it in a weekend.
Yeah.
It's actually about layering your home with yourself, and that takes years. It really does. So there's little projects in there for colour, little projects for style, and then right at the end of the book, it's about bringing it all together.
I also noticed at the end you've got your environment, where you are, and how that affects also.
Yeah.
So you don't want to sort of go against. I suppose if you've got great views of the Blue Mountains outside, that would have an effect. Or if you've got the ocean out in front of your door, that would have an effect as well on how you should be thinking about your colour.
Exactly,
your
exactly. It's funny, a lot of the Blue Mountains and a lot of places like in Victoria's like your Dalesford, you've got a very eclectic, artistic community that's in there, and you think you've got all this beautiful nature, and you end up people having in their homes a lot of eclectic colours of bold reds and blues and golds and clashing colours, because it's a very artist community. And I think they take a lot of their inspiration from nature and interpret it in a whole different way. So just because you've got that beautiful nature environment doesn't mean you just have to have all those greens in your house. But when you're trying to do the style in a very measured way with the environment that you've got, it's good to take a formula of what's there to get you started and then build from there.
I have a statement that I want to read out to you.
Okay, scaring me.
Books are the perfect adornment to any room. Discuss.
Yeah, absolutely. They're great, you know, when decorating for selling houses and getting the houses ready, they're great for stacking on, shelves and coffee tables. I love books because they're tactile. I love them because they tell a story of the people that live in that room. And if you look at the titles that people have on their coffee tables, on their bookshelves, you get a little bit of an insight who the people are.
Shana Blaze, thank you very much.
Thank you. Now, you had a picture in there and you said you were going to show me.
Oh, yeah.
I'm intrigued. Okay.
Well,
I think I know which one it is.
As I flicked through, a particular picture just leapt out at me. And my mind saw it first and then looked at the books below, of course.
I know.
What is going on there?
Okay. That is a Jonathan Adler ornament. It actually was part of a big picture, and then they condensed it, and I went, oh, okay. And I think when it went to print, it wasn't meant to look like
that. This is the bigger picture.
That is the bigger picture.
Yeah, and it doesn't stand out as much.
It doesn't stand out as much, but you know what? Starts a conversation, so it's a good thing.
certainly does. Because in my mind, my eye is always drawn to the books.
Yes.
And then when I saw the ornament, I went, whoa.
Well, if, you know, you want to get people talking, just do something like that.
Shana Blaze, thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Shana's book is available from booktopia.com.au right now.